guys, I am gonna try to just do a quick tip for you guys, and I am going to explain why I choose the black paint that I do. And to me, there's two main ones to really choose from, but there are a lot of black paints out there. And if you are interested in really reading in depth about all the different options, I would recommend that you go to handprint.com, where you can read about all kinds of different paints and their characteristics. And I will put a link to that in the description in this video. Okay, let's get started. For the purposes of this video, I am going to be testing two black colors. One is going to be M. Graham Ivory Black, and the other one is going to be Winsor & Newton Lamp Black. And here I am just mixing together some ivory black with some ultramarine blue. And I just wanted to do this so I could show you guys how it mixes with another color. And then I am going to do the same with the lamp black. So, and now here I'm painting a little puddle of lamp black. And to me, you can already see how it's more evenly coating the paper in just a flat wash. And it is dull. This is why artists always say, don't use flat black. Use a mix to create your blacks, because it is. It's just a flat black. And as you can see, I think it granulated out more, and handprint.com agrees with me on that it granulates out more. And that can make an interesting effect, especially if you're like painting rocks or something like that, like in a landscape. But I'm not sure that is what I usually want it to do, say when I'm using it just to paint in the iris of an animal or some little detail, or if I'm covering a large area of fur like I was in this painting. I didn't want it to granulate here. This is an original. This is a painting I did of my cat, and I used lamp black in this painting, and I added a lot of other colors to it, and that made a lot more interesting black, but it also covered well, and there were no surprises, and I could control where I wanted my dark darks and my lighter darks much better. And I feel like this ivory black granulates out more and just doesn't provide as even coverage. See how down here it really gets lighter where there was more water? So that's ivory black. And then lamp black, it just has a more even coating of the paper. And here's where I mixed it with ultramarine blue. It mixed nicely with that, and the blue kind of glows through nicely without it being blotchy or anything. And there's just really nice paper coverage. So I choose to paint mostly with lamp black. I went over to handprint.com and looked up the different properties of each. And the M. Graham Ivory Black is considered more transparent. It's equally as staining. It has about the same amount of value range, but to me, it's easier to get medium to dark tones with the lamp black than the ivory black. And then the ivory black is also more granulating. As you can see in this mix, you can see how it granulated out a bit. And then for handprint also measures how much a paint blossoms, which many of you may know as the cauliflower effect. And this basically happens when little nubbly edges are created along the outside of a wash where the painting was starting to dry, and then you put paint that was too wet, unless you're trying to create a cauliflower. And handprint says lamp black cauliflowers more than ivory black, and my test supports this. And then for diffusion, that's how much the paint spreads in a wet wash. And the lamp black diffuses more. And then lightfastness, they're both pretty much equally lightfast. All right, you guys, I hope you're having a good week. Bye. 'Kitty, really, kitty. And I'm kind of cuddling with my kitty while I make this video.